Isang magandang Sabado po ng umaga sa ating lahat. Ako po ay nagpapasalamat sa ating Panginoon at nagising tayo muli sa araw na ito, unang Sabado ng buwan ng mga puso o ng Feb-ibig. At dalangin ko na sa umagang ito ay kayo ay nasa malusog na pangangatawan at pag-iisip. Welcome po sa 1143 DZMR para po sa ating programang Usapang Pangkalusugan. Ako po muli si Dr. Jennifer Gatioan-Sy, your program host, at samahan niyo po ako sa loob ng kalahating oras at pag-usapan natin ang isang napapanahong usapin. Ito po ay tungkol, hindi po sa puso, pero tungkol pa rin po sa isang very timely na topic because today we celebrate World Cancer Day. February 4 is World Cancer Day. It originated in February 4 of 2000 at the World Summit Against Cancer for the New Millennium in Paris. And the Paris Charter aims to promote research, prevent cancer, improve patient services, raise awareness and mobilize the global community to make progress against cancer and includes the adoption of World Cancer Day. So yun po ang panggagalingan ng ating topic sa araw na to, no? Yung cancer awareness. Bakit nga pa kailangan natin bigyan ng pansin itong cancer? Alam niyo po bang there are around 10 million people who die each year from cancer. So, mas madami pa rin kaysa sa COVID. So, this is a pandemic that has been with us for such a long time. That is more than HIV, AIDS, malaria, and tuberculosis combined. And by 2030, experts project cancer death to rise around 13 million in 1 year if we do not act now. So, what happens when we act? Alam niyo po bang, if we act, more than 1/3 cases of cancer can be prevented or maiiwasan. And another 1/3 can be cured or pwedeng pagalingin if detected early and treated properly. Yun. So, imagine nyo, around 60% ay pwede nating malampasan itong challenge of cancer. And by implementing resource-appropriate strategies on prevention, early detection, and treatment, we can save millions of lives every year. But today, we know more about cancer than ever before because of research and innovations, and we have witnessed extraordinary breakthroughs in medicine, diagnostics, and even scientific knowledge. Therefore, the more we know, the more progress we can make in reducing the risk factors, increasing prevention, and improving cancer diagnosis, prevention, treatment, and care. So, pwede po nating bigyan ng magandang pag-asa ang ating paglaban sa cancer. In the recent years, ang United Nations and the World Health Organizations and other agencies have recognized the urgent need for global commitment. No? When leaders speak up and take actions, we give ourselves a chance to make history and to move towards a world without cancer. Sa ngayon po, more than half or around 65% of cancer deaths ay nangyayari po sa mga mahihirap na bansa. And even if we live in a higher income countries, hindi pa rin to po pantay, no? Because there are inequities that exist among lower income, indigenous immigrants, refugees, and rural communities. So, ang goal po is equitable access to cancer prevention, diagnosis, treatment, and care that could save millions of lives. So yun po ang goal ng ating cancer awareness program. Okay? So what is cancer? As I've said a while ago, no, ang cancer po is it causes death but it can be preventable or some of them can be curable now. And Why are we raising awareness? Alam niyo po ba na just to treat cancer, there's around $1.16 trillion na igagastos for cancer treatment. Ayan. So what is cancer nga ba? Pag naririnig natin itong big C, no, nakakatakot. Cancer is a disease which occurs when changes in a group of normal cells, na yung mga normal na cell ng ating katawan, ay nagkakaroon na tinatawag nating uncontrolled, abnormal growth, na kung saan nagkakaroon ng mga bukol na tinatawag po nating tumor. No? So this is true in most cases except leukemia o yung cancer sa dugo. Kasi syempre hindi naman magbubukol, no? At pag etong mga bukol na to ay hindi pinansin o hindi binigyan ng tamang lunas, lalaki itong mga to at kakalat sa kanyang mga surrounding normal tissues, even to other parts of the body, no? Biyahe yan, sasabay yan sa ating dugo or the lymphatic systems at pwedeng maapektuhan ng iba't ibang parte ng ating katawan. So, cancer tumors can be divided into three. Yung po tinatawag nating benign o yung hindi cancerous and not really life-threatening, but they tend to grow quite slowly, no? And sometimes they do not spread to other parts of the body and usually are made up of cells similar to the normal or healthy cells. They will only cause a problem if they grow very large, no? Dahil sobrang laki niya, nagkakaroon ng mga compression, no? Naiipit yung mga normal cells. So kailangan tanggalin, but they are technically benign. The other one is what you called malignant, no? Pag sinabing malignant tumors, they are faster growing than the benign tumors and they have the ability to spread and destroy yung mga kapitbahay na normal cells. Cells of malignant tumors can break off from the main or the primary tumor, no, at nanganganak siya, spreading to the other parts of the body, known as metastasis. Ayun, kumalat na. And upon invading healthy cells, dun sa new site, they will continue to divide and grow. Okay? These secondary sites are known as metastasis and kaya tinatawag na natin metastatic cancer. Yung pangatlo naman po yung tinatawag natin precancerous or premalignant. Okay? So this describes the condition involving abnormal cells na pwedeng maging malignant. So yun po yung tatlong klase. Now, iba-iba po ang klase ng cancer. Okay? Cancers can be classified according to the type of cell na kung saan sila mag-uumpisa. Meron po tayong tinatawag na carcinoma. Ito po ay nag-uumpisa sa mga lining ng ating mga organs. Sila yung lining ng ating bituka, lining ng ating breast, ng colon. So, dun po nag-uumpisa. And these carcinomas will invade those surrounding tissues and organs at kakalat siya sa ating mga lymphatic system. The most common form of carcinoma are in the group of yung pong breast cancer, sa parehong kababaihan, kalalakihan, but mostly sa kababaihan. Prostate cancer among male, lung cancer, and colon cancer. So dito pumapasok ang carcinoma. The other one is yung tinatawag nating sarcoma. This is a type of malignant tumor of the bone or any soft tissues tulad ng fat, muscle, blood vessels o daluyan ng ating dugo, nerves and other connective tissues that support and surround the organ. So yung mga supporting. Ang pinaka-common forms of sarcoma are leiomyosarcoma, dun sa mga muscle cells, liposarcoma dun sa fat and osteosarcoma dun sa bones. Okay? Now, the other type is the lymphoma and myeloma. Ito po ay yung cancer na ang tinitira ay ang ating mismong immune system na siyang panlaban sana sa mga infeksyon. So, lymphoma is a cancer of the lymphatic system which runs all through the body kasi Parallel to sa ating blood vessels, no? So therefore, pwede silang tumubo maski saan. Yun naman pong myeloma or what you call multiple myeloma, eh, nag-uumpisa po siya sa plasma cells o siya yung white part ng ating blood na gumagawa ng antibodies to help fight infection. So, ang nangyayari pag ikaw ay may multiple myeloma, this cancer can affect the cell's ability to produce antibodies effectively. So, baksak ang iyong immune system. The other one, leukemia, sa blood pa rin to. This is the cancer of the white blood cells and the bone marrow, no, kung saan doon na-form ang ating mga dugo, no? Maraming klaseng subtypes ang leukemia. Yung tinatawag natin lymphocytic, chronic lymphocytic. Hindi na natin di-discuss yung mga yan. Other types of cancer are the brain and spinal cord cancer or what you call central nervous system. Some are benign, no, mabagal, pero some are also malignant. Ngayon ang tanong, saan ba nanggagaling itong mga cancer na to? Ano ba ang dahilan kung bakit tayo nagkaka-cancer? So, cancer can be caused by a number of different factors, no? As with many other illnesses, marami pong dahilan. Most cancers are the result of exposure to a number of different causal factors. Ibig sabihin, na-expose tayo sa mga bagay na hindi maganda sa ating katawan. So, ito yung mga tinatawag na modifiable. Pwede mong iwasan sana. Around one-third of cancer cases can be prevented, no? By reducing our exposure to them, no? Specifically, our behavior, our lifestyle. So, yun yung tinatawag nating modifiable or preventable cancers. So, it is important to note, no? Sometimes, ang cause din ng ating cancer is our lifestyle, okay? Our exposures tulad ng alcohol, no? Alak. The evidence that all types of alcoholic drinks are a cause of a number of cancers is now stronger than ever before. Alcohol can increase the risk of six types of cancer. Yung tinatawag nating colorectal sa ating intestines, breast cancer, mouth, pharynx, and larynx. So, ibig sabihin, the mouth and throat, esophageal, liver, and stomach. So, digestive, syempre, kung saan nga naman dadaan. Diba? Sunog talaga, di ba? Sunog atay, sunog digestive system. Okay? So, the evidence suggests that in general, the most alcohol drinks people consume, the higher the risk of many cancers, and that even moderate alcohol intake increases the risk of cancer. And being overweight or obese as well, no, can also be linked to increased risk of developing 12 different cancers, including bowel and pancreatic cancers. In general, greater weight gain, lalo na sa adults, is associated with greater cancer risk. Ayan. So, kailangan mag-diet. Speaking of diet, no? Diet and nutrition. Experts suggest that diets and nutritional intakes, particularly diet high in red meats, ayan, or processed meats, salted foods, and low in fruits and vegetables have an impact on cancer risk, particularly the colorectal, nasopharyngeal, and stomach cancer. How about physical activity or physical inactivity? Okay? So, kung tayo ay nag-exercise, this not only help us to reduce excess body fat and the cancer risk associated with this, but being physically active can help to reduce the risk of developing colon, breast, and sa kababaihan, endometrial cancers. Tobacco contains at least 80 different cancer-causing substances. So, ito yung tawag nating carcinogenic agents. And when smoke is inhaled, the chemicals will enter the lungs, pass into the bloodstream, and transported throughout the whole body. And this is why smoking or chewing tobacco not only causes lung and mouth cancers, but is also related to many other cancers. The more a person smokes, the younger they start, and the longer they keep smoking, all further increase the risk of cancer. Currently, tobacco use is responsible for around 22% or 1 out of 5 causes of death. Ayan. So, yan yung mga modifiable. Other modifiable are the ionizing radiation or the man-made sources of radiation. So, ito yung mga X-rays, gamma rays, prolonged and unprotected exposure to UV rays from the sun, yung mga nag-expose. Pero sa atin, takot na tayo magpaaraw dahil ayaw natin umiting. Pero sa mga, ano, mga puti, no? White-skinned individuals, gustong-gusto nila yan. No? So, they're at risk. Workplace hazards, no? Tulad ng yung noong panahon, yung asbestos. Okay? So, pero ngayon, okay, yung mga lead poisoning. Okay? Based sa trabaho. And infections. Alam niyo po bang may mga viruses or bacteria that can cause cancer? So, number one na po dun sa cervical cancer ng mga kababaihan, no? 70% of cervical cancers is caused by what you call the human papilloma or the HPV infections. So, isang klase naman ng lymphoma, yung tinatawag nating non-Hodgkin's lymphoma o yung mga liver cancer, no? Cirrhosis is caused by hepatitis B and hepatitis C virus. Ayan. So, yan yung mga infection na pwedeng mag-cause ng cancer. May mga bagay naman na hindi natin maiiwasan. Yung tinatawag nating non-modifiable risk factors. Ito ang ating edad. As we age, no? The longer people live, the more exposure they will be to some carcinogens. Therefore, more time for genetic changes or mutations in their cells. Cancer-causing substances. So, ngayon sa panahon natin, because of the food that we eat, no? Ayan, pwede din tayong na-expose na. Ayan, yung mga sun rays, ayan. Genetics. Some people are unfortunately born with a genetically inherited high risk for certain specific cancer. Tinatawag natin, predispose ka. Ayan. For example, sa mga kababaihan na meron sa kanilang genes na meron genes na pwedeng mag-cause ng breast cancer. So, example dito si Angelina Jolie na yung lola niya, yung mommy niya ay parehong namatay sa breast cancer, and nung she got tested, she is at high risk for breast cancer kaya nagpa-mastectomy na siya agad. Ayan. However, less than 5% of all breast cancer is known to be due to genes pa din. So, it's more of high, ano lang talaga, they are high risk. Ayan. The immune system. Ito yung mga hindi natin maiwasan. People who have weakened immune systems are at more risk of developing certain types of cancer. This includes people who have organ transplants, plus people who also have HIV or AIDS, kasi ang tinitira po ng HIV ay yung weakening of their immune system. Ngayon, ano po ba ang mga simptomas ng isang taong may cancer? With so many different types of cancers, the symptoms are varied, iba-iba, and depend on where the disease is located. But in general, ito po yung signs and symptoms that we should look out for, no? Nasabi natin, most cancers are mga bukol. So, yun ang una mong titingnan, mga unusual lumps or swelling na dating wala, no? Cancerous lumps are often painless and may increase in size as the cancer progresses. Sa lungs, meron tayong tinatawag na coughing, breathlessness, or difficulty in swallowing. So, be aware of persistent coughing episodes or difficulty in swallowing. Baka may nagbabara na. Sa gastrointestinal system, meron naman pag-iba o pagkakaiba ng iyong bowel habits. Ibig sabihin, kung dati hindi ka, everyday kang dumudumi, biglang once a week, once every 2 weeks, or kung minsan naman ay nagkakaroon ka ng diarrhea or there are blood found in your stools. Yeah. Speaking of blood, pwedeng unexpected bleeding din in some parts of the body, vaginal bleeding, okay, or blood in the urine or coughing out blood. Unexplained weight loss. Ayan. A large amount of unexplained and unintentional weight loss over a short period of time. Biglang bumagsak ang iyong katawan. And other than that, mabilis kang mapagod, no? Lack of energy, pain, may mga masasakit na dati ay wala naman doon. Unexplained, ongoing pain. Sa balat ay may mga biglang tumutubong parang mga nunal-nunal, okay? So, look for changes in size, shape, or color, or biglang nagli-bleed din. Sa pag-ihi, lalo na sa mga kalalakihan, no? Yung complications with urinating, it's either more frequent or hirap kang umihi. Ayan. Sa kababaihan, unusual breast changes. Ayan, yun yung mga tinitingnan sa breast cancer. Ayan. Or mga ulcer or mga sugat-sugat. Ayan, sa bibig din. Heartburn or indigestion. Dahil nga sa mga esophageal. Heavy night sweats. Ayan, so yan yung mga signs and symptoms. So how can we prevent cancer? Nasabi na natin kanina, no? There are preventable cancers. Okay, or yung mga tinatawag nating modifiable, and over one third of them can be prevented. So how? Okay, so reduce your exposure to those risk factors tulad ng sigarilyo, diet, exercise. With regards to infections, cervical cancer has already vaccines for that sa mga both lalaki at babae. Okay, although babae lang ang may cervix, but the virus that can cause the cervical cancer can also infect kalalakihan. So, yung cervical vaccine, the HPV vaccine being given to girls can also be given to boys nowadays. Okay? To prevent the human papilloma virus to infect male para hindi rin niya na-infect yung future female partner niya. Alcohol, lessen your alcohol, no? Environmental pollutions, occupational hazards, radiation, yan yung mga pwede nating maiwasan. Aside from HPV vaccine, sa atay, hepatitis B vaccine, pwede rin pong ibigay yan sa ating bansa. Pagkapanganak na pagkapanganak, ibinibigay na yan. So, yan yung mga pwede nating maiwasan. With regards naman po sa early detection, there are a number of cancers that can be identified early. Okay? So, may mga cost-effective test na dato tayong pwedeng ipagawa at pwede niyong isama yan sa mga routine check-up natin. May mga radiologic procedures, may mga blood tests, ayan, o yung mga sa kababaihan, mga pap smear, sa lalaki, rectal exam for prostate. So, yan pwede ninyong ipagawa. And with regards to cancer staging, no? Sinasabi natin kung ito ay localized, mga stage 1, 2, 3, 4, ayan sa doktor na yan. So, inaalam natin yung staging just to know the prognosis kung paano natin i-manage ang cancer ng bawat pasyente. Because there are many ways to manage or treat cancer. Pwedeng surgery, kung hindi pa ito kumalat, it can be removed, no? Entirely. Okay, without undergoing chemotherapy or radiotherapy. Kung kumalat naman, pwede po yung tinatawag nating radiation treatment. No? Okay, so to reduce the tumor size or destroy the cancer cells. Ayan, so may mga ganong treatment. Chemotherapy, no, use chemicals to interfere with the way the cells divide. Ayan, so parang they will destroy those cancer cells. Okay, na kung saan, kung minsan, even the normal cells ay naapektuhan. So, alam na po yan ng mga ating oncologists or cancer specialists dahil meron silang tinatawag nating management protocol kung kailan nila gagawin itong mga to. Immunotherapy uses the body's own immune system to fight the cancer tumor. So, mayayan na yung mga bago. Hormone therapy. Several cancers have been linked to some types of hormones including breast and prostate cancer. Kaya, nagagawan din. For those who are at high risk because of the gene, may gene therapy rin to replace damaged genes with ones that work to address a root cause of cancer. Ayan, so genetics na. Ayan. The goal is, of course, to survive. Ayan, meron tayong tinatawag na survivorship care. This includes no issues related to follow-up care. Okay, yung the improvement of the quality of life and psychological and emotional health. No? So, part of this is the future anti-cancer treatment. Not just for the patient, but even for the members, no, family members. At kung talagang late na, itiyatawag natin palliative care. No, this care runs throughout the patient's journey from the diagnosis to cure or even end of life. And is designed to relieve symptoms and improve the patient's quality of life. No, it doesn't end there. Okay? So you can still live a life even if you have cancer. Diba? So as we end, no, what does the Word of God say about cancer? So sa Bible, wala kang makikitang word na cancer. However, this does not mean na hindi yun na-address. Kasi may nababasa tayong mga sakit, no? Nung mga kapanahunan na yun. When Jesus came here, no, He healed all diseases that were brought to Him. So, probably may mga iba dun ay may mga cancer. No? However, cancer, like all disease, is a result of the curse of sin that entered this world during the fall. Diba? So, from the start pa lang sa Genesis, sabi, curse is the ground for thy sake because of Adam and Eve, our great-great lolo and lola. So, pag sinabi mong ground, the whole earth, okay, that's part of the fall, okay? The earth has been cursed because of the original sin and all man will die from dust to dust. These diseases, no? Cancer, COVID, are not technically punishment. They are the result of living in the fallen world and upon a cursed earth. And believers and unbelievers alike develop cancer and other diseases that could lead to physical death. We need to remember that in life of every believer of Jesus, God works all things together for their good, no? And all things includes cancer. And the wonderful thing is that even though in this life, on this cursed earth, we are subject to diseases like cancer, the difference for those who believe is there is hope. Okay? We have the living hope. In the book of Psalms 106, it says passage that give us confident assurance that there will be an end to the ills of this world. Sabi sa Psalms 103, verses 1 to 4, praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being, praise His holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit or death and crowns you with love and compassion. So, does this mean that if you are a follower of Jesus, you will be healed of cancer or any diseases in this life? Well, we have seen it for the past few years during the pandemic. Even the followers of Jesus died, no? Rather, the same God who forgives us of our sin will one day bring us to a place that He has prepared for us. God's redemption preserves us from the ultimate destruction, no? Yung talagang spiritual death. Okay? So, ang goal ng ating Panginoon is to redeem us from that second death. And the final victory over the curse of sin is already ours in Jesus. So, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 55 to 57, or 54 to 57, death is swallowed up in victory, no, when Jesus Christ resurrected. So, O death, where is your sting? O grave, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. One day, God will wipe away all our tears, and there shall be no more death, no more dying, no more sorrow, no more pain, for the former things are passed away. So that's what we will be hoping for. Okay, so that's it po for today sa ating programang Usapang Pangkalusugan. Nawa, sa kalahating oras ay may ibigay po tayong linaw tungkol po sa paksa natin sa araw na to, World Cancer Day. Okay, so let us all surrender everything to the Lord, our life, our everyday life. Mamuhay po tayo ng malusog ang ating katawan at kaisipan. Abangan niyo po muli ako sa susunod na Sabado para po sa ating programang Usapang Pangkalusugan. Dito lamang po sa 1143 DZMR, a proud member of KDP. Ating tandaan ng ating kalusugan ay kayamanang di mapapantayan. Happy weekend po sa ating lahat!